wonder, Spencer, whether Sugar Ray Leonard might have any political ambitions once he's finished with boxing.
Why's that?
Reception he got here tonight. If he's running for office, I'm certain he'll be elected.
It was a better reception, I feel, than the mayor got. It was a,
well, and then he had mixed,
you know, a little mixture as far as the cheers with a few boos spotted in.
Well, Sugar Ray took a bold step. He embraced Mayor Barry. That's what made me think of it. We get to fight time, Pinklon Thomas looks unhappier and unhappier.
Well, the longer this, these introductions become, the man can become a veritable volcano. Who might have known? It's going to be interesting as they come to the center of a ring.
Pinklon didn't want to come to the center of the ring. He's definitely an unhappy camper.
Sylvester Stevens, the referee.
Now, fellas, whoever scores the knockdown, I'd like me to go to the furthest corner.
Stare.
I want you to watch your punches. Watch your head. Watch your nose weapon, okay? Keep your gloves closed when you're punching at all times. Good luck to both corners.
So, Riddick Bowe against Pinklon Thomas. Let's check out the tail of the tape and the size of these two heavyweights as they get set to square off in a 10-rounder. 9 years age differential for Thomas. Height Bowe a couple of inches, and the reach, Riddick Bowe's got four on him. We're underway, both with light trunks, but Pinklon Thomas with a black stripe. What kind of shape was he in? Can he still do it at the age of 32? As he told Mike Holly, what's wrong with being 32? Hey, I don't think there's anything wrong with being 32. When you're a fighter, it could be a lot wrong, particularly if you had as rocky and roller coaster a career as Pinklon Thomas.
Well, not only did Thomas take those back-to-back beatings by Mike Tyson and then Evander Holyfield, but he also had a serious bout with drug addiction. He says he Monday will be his 19-month anniversary off the alcohol and drugs, and so apparently he's been successful so far in getting rid of those addictions. But that couldn't have helped his physical condition. And I think Pinklon looks a little puffy. In fact, looks older than 32. Just doesn't appear to be right. Well, there's the big right hand. You know, Bo's going to look to take him out with that chopping right, Spencer. That's the trademark. Riddick Bowe, he'll hurt you with a left hook and then bang you out with a right hand. Pinklon Thomas has to establish himself here in the opening round. There he got out jabbed by Bowe.
Nicely as Riddick Bowe. His last win, a three-round knockout of Art Tuckett.
Good left hook thrown by Thomas. He just hit the top of Bowe's head, but that was a good shot.
Thomas Cooper has been a knockout except for two fights. His third fight against Gary Lane, a four-round decision. Three fights ago, Eddie Gonzalez, an eight-rounder. Also a decision.
I gotta tell you, Riddick Bowe looked horrible in that fight against him. Just a lackluster, albeit winning now.
Knocked out Manny Contreras in the first and Art Tuckett in the third.
Come on,
stripes. And the white stripes.
He's wobbled. Pinklon Thomas is wobbling.
Thomas getting puffy under his right eye. That left jab sticking in there by Riddick Bowe. Scheduled 10 rounds here. First round, you go with Riddick Bowe.
No doubt about it. Pinklon Thomas really landed one punch. Left hook to the top of Bowe's head. A little showboating by Riddick Bowe. No need for that.
When you watch Thomas throw that jab, it has no sting on it. He's just kind of pushing it out. Push, push, push. Instead of zap, zap, zap.
Well, what Bowe should do is concentrate his attack on the body. You can see the rolls around Pinklon Thomas's midsection. He's not in the greatest shape. Already puffing. What Pinky Thomas is doing now is just cashing in on his former good name.
Thomas won the championship with a 12-round decision over Tim Weatherspoon in Las Vegas back in 1984. Defended it once with a victory over Michael Weaver. And then was beaten using a 12-round decision to Trevor Burdick in Washington.
There's the body attack by Bowe. He's got him hurt.
Thomas is in trouble.
You saw
good combination.
You saw the knees wobble. That's the sign of an old Finnish fighter. Nice uppercut by Bowe on the inside, right off the bat. It's really just a matter of time, Spencer, because Thomas is offering no offense of his own. Good left hook by Bowe.
Just blindly coming in, and there's some blood.
There's a cut.
On the eye, right eye of Pinklon Thomas.
There's a cut. I think it's on the lid of the eye, Spencer, and it's coming right down into the eye. Good left hook by Bowe. Sylvester Stevens, he's warily eyeing Pinklon Thomas's cut eye. When Thomas throws punches, he's missing. He's not even close with his shots. Well, so far, Pinklon Thomas has really shown nothing.
Well, it has been all Riddick Bowe as we get ready for the third round. How much further do you think Pinklon Thomas can go?
Well, I thought he'd get taken out in that round. Again, he's shown nothing. And, you know, while I'm being highly critical of Pinklon Thomas, I don't mean to denigrate Riddick Bowe. He did not put Pinklon Thomas into this fight. It's time, past time, really, to step up the opposition for Riddick Bowe. He's too good for his own good.
As we were talking before, you think maybe a little too slow there, right now.
I think the timetable has to be sped up. Riddick Bowe, at the age of 23, still learning, yes, but he needs better opposition so people can see just how good he is. It's really not fair to him to keep fighting the Pinklon Thomas type of moments.
It's strange how the heavyweight division, kind of like women's tennis, was dominated by one or two people for so long a period of time.
Well, that double left hook really hurt Thomas. He's out on his feet. Riddick Bowe going to town.
The bravado is gone from Pinklon Thomas.
They say Bowe knows boxing. I hope Pinklon knows it's time to back it in. Time to quit boxing.
Bowe knows. This Bowe knows, too. Good left hook.
And Sylvester Stevens, the ref, Spencer has to be thinking about stopping it unless Thomas answers back. Say this for Pinklon, Thomas still has the heart of a champion. A lot of guys would have, you know, laid down, would have gone right to the canvas after taking some of the shots he took. But he's in there, so now he's trying to come back.
Bo's just biding his time.
Bo's looking to take him out with that uppercut on the inside.
Now, this is not the old Pinklon Thomas. Pinklon Thomas is going to have to sit down, watch the tape of this, and make a decision about his life. He's fatigued.
He's staggering really about the ring, and it's sad to see it, but an age-old boxing sprint is laid out.
Like we were trying to do.
Exactly. Now it looks like that left eye is puffed up, too. Although Thomas comes back with a left hook. Count the punches Thomas has landed, though, on one hand. But he's going to get through this round, it looks like.
Really cool. What a physical presence. 6'5", 230 pounds. I mean, he's tight end material. Linebacker material. 6'3", 227 for Pinklon Thomas.
Well, I'm trying to figure out Riddick Bowe right now. I don't, you know, he should go right on the offensive and take this man out of there. You can see the swelling around the left eye, the left jaw. There's the swelling around the left side of the face of Pinklon Thomas. That's testimony to the physical beating that Riddick Bowe has been dishing out.
This is the fourth round. You just measured him right there. Fourth round of a scheduled 10-rounder.
Nice 1-2 by Bo.
There's nothing left in the Pinklon Thomas punches.
I think Riddick Bowe may have had tougher work in sparring with Art Tucker. I think he'd get a scolding from the dean of training, but I think he's just frustrated. You know, he had the man hurt about five times now in the bout, and he's still banging away at like a statue, and that's about as mobile as Pinklon Thomas has been. It's like a statue that doesn't want to go down. So Riddick Bowe just keeps chipping away.
Now, what's the problem there?
Oh, tape loose apparently on the glove. Right glove of Pinklon Thomas, and at least that gives Pinklon Thomas a breather.
Something he can use.
And Riddick Bowe catching a huff and puff in his corner. That's what it is. The trainer is fixing the tape.
Riddick Bowe just waiting for his cosmetical pair.
Used to be a well-known trick in boxing when your man needed a breather, you put a cigarette hole in his glove between rounds. And Another trick is to unloosen the tape.
Teach him how to spit out that mouthpiece, too. Well, we had a tail of the tape earlier. This is a tail of the tape version 2.
Well, Pinklot Thomas seems to be upset. I don't know. He's mad at his corner. He's not happy.
Excuse me, Mike. He's mad at his corner. You put the tape on me, let me go back in the ring.
Right, exactly. But my point is, it just doesn't do Pinklot any good to get mad at the corner.
No.
Get mad at Riddick Bowe, that's another story. Now the referee is not happy. Sylvester Stevens, the referee, wants the other glove fixed, apparently. So both the left and right gloves.
If these guys were pit crew in Indianapolis, they wouldn't get the car back on the track. Meanwhile, back in the center of the ring.
About the fighting heart of the boxers, I should point out, 79 years young, Eddie Futch in the corner tonight, despite the fact that he can barely walk. He's having hip replacement surgery, going to have an artificial hip surgically implanted next week, but yet he's here with his man, Riddick Bowe.
This could be the last hurrah right here for Pinklot Thomas as he's trapped. Pretty restful fourth round, and he comes out here trying to throw some punches.
Despite his ailing hip, Eddie Futch is moving more nimbly than Pinklot Thomas. So Riddick Bowe's job, quite simply, is to take this man out of here now.
Certain things that can indicate and let you think that the possibility exists. The fatigue on the fighter who is ahead because of the effort he's expended, but right here, there's just doesn't seem to be any chance.
Well, Riddick Bowe really hasn't been hit a real solid shot. There he lands a nice right hand.
Thomas is in trouble. Good uppercut that time by Riddick Bowe. You want to see the flow in Riddick Bowe. The stuff of which champions are made of. And you see the potential there. And occasionally we've seen those kind of flurries, but you'd like to see more of them.
There he's triple jabbing poor Pinklon Thomas. Pinklon Thomas just a game loser at this stage of his career. Took this fight for very little money, Pinklon Thomas. And looks like the end of the trail. This is one of those kinds of fights, Spencer, where the loser, but the best offer he'll get maybe is to wind up as a sparring partner for a Riddick Bowe, the top young heavyweight. That's sad, but that's the reality of boxing. Pinklon Thomas at the age of 32, who knows how badly his body was ravaged by the various bouts he's had with drugs. As a young man, he had a long period of heroin addiction. He beat that. The last few years, he battled crack cocaine problems, alcohol problems. And so he may not have the typical body of a 32-year-old former heavyweight champ. May have paid the price for all those years of drug abuse.
Right here, after that early flurry in the sixth round, there's the big right hand by Riddick Bowe. Thomas may yet weather another round.
He wanted to be a singer. Well, I think Pinklon Thomas may have sung his last professional boxing song.
Well, you asked him before, what about a singing career? What did he say?
Well, he kind of snarled at me on that one, too. I didn't mean it in a smart-alecky kind of way. He had a good voice, but just didn't have the right focus. When you're heavyweight champion of the world, you should be looking at pedal record albums out in the hallway of the or the hotel lobby the day of the fight.
Certainly, bedtime priority mix-up.
He'd be singing the blues after this one. Well, you know that Riddick Bowe wants KO next to Pinklon Thomas's name on his record. You know that Riddick Bowe won't be happy, not to mention Eddie Kutch and manager Rock Newman, they'll be very unhappy as well should Pinklon Thomas somehow last the 10-round limit here.
In the seventh round right now, and again, only twice in his 18-fight career as an opponent gone the route with Riddick Bowe. That was in his third professional fight I mentioned earlier against Gary Lane, a 4-round decision, an 8-round decision 3 fights ago in April of this year in Las Vegas against Eddie Gonzalez.
Well, it's hard to criticize the record of an 18-0 Riddick Bowe, but if I could voice one minor criticism, it's that Riddick seems to lose his concentration sometimes.
Right here, Pinklon Thomas is in a lot of trouble. Riddick Bowe looks like he's going to put him away here in the seventh round. He is defenseless at this point, this Pinklon Thomas.
Well, nobody could really ask for their money back. Pinklon Thomas, his skills totally eroded. I don't know how he stays up, Spencer.
He's rocking back and forth. He's off balance.
And Riddick Bowe can punch. Bowe has definite power. These are not love taps.
certainly out on his feet. The uppercut, the overhead right, another uppercut, and Pinkland Thomas is still standing.
I don't know why the referee's not stopping this fight.
Look at this. The man cannot stand.
This should be stopped. This is pathetic. There's just no point.
There's no way he can win this fight. He can only get very seriously hurt. There's the referee. That's what they call him, Sylvester Stevens. And just why he is continuing to lie. Now the doctor is coming in the corner to take a look.
Well, it's about time, Spencer. We've talked about that for rounds.
Is there a doctor in the house? He's here now. And I want to see if they're going to allow this fight to continue. Pinkland Thomas didn't know where he was.
Totally out on his feet, and that's how a fighter might be. Without a neurologist, don't have to go to a fighter. There you see the pounding. I mean, it's just one shot after another. It's hammer time. And MC Hammer is Riddick Bowe. The hammeree, Pinkland Thomas.
Now look at this. The man can't even stand right here. Even when he's not being hit, he's rocking backwards.
Yet here we go. More of the same.
And you wonder, you know, we're criticizing the referee. What about his corner?
Well,
throw it in.
Referee, the doctor, I think there's enough criticism to pass around. I don't know. This is a poorly officiated fight.
Hey, would anybody criticize if he went to a commercial right now?
It would be the humane thing to do. I don't know what's wrong with Thomas's corner. Why they don't throw the towel in. I mean, this is pathetic. And these people supposedly care about Pinkland Thomas. Trainer Willie Barber not making a move, just watching the slaughter.
The left uppercut by Riddick Bowe as he continues to confuse Pinkland Thomas with a punching bag. That's what the former champion has become tonight.
I guess we're both editorializing, Spencer, but this deserves it.
Well, there's, you know, a former great tennis champion once said to me, Fred Perry. I said, come on out in the court. He said, no, I don't come out in the court. I want people to remember me the way I was, not the way I am today. Fred Perry, of course, three-time Wimbledon champion. You'd like to allow this man at least the sense of dignity to be remembered a bit as to what he once was instead of what he's become tonight. Become a punching bag.
This is really a bad advertisement for professional boxing.
I think we've said enough. Let's just go, folks, you can watch it at all, and we'll watch it also. I think we've made our point very strongly. This fight should be stopped.
This is ammunition for the AMA and other people who want to abolish boxing.
Stop it,
and finally like Barber said the right thing. He said, yes, that's enough.
It was a no-doubter from about the third round on, and hopefully Pinkland Thomas will come out of this just a rather bruised man and can look toward the future for something else. How he was able to survive that barrage for eight rounds is beyond me. Why he was allowed to survive it, why the referee, why his own corner allowed the barrage to continue.
The corner of Pinkland Thomas retired their fighter, the winner now by TKO with a record of 19-0.